That's it, guys. So, the title sequence is a bit bad right here. I'm still kind of getting used to doing all of this. I don't know how it will translate over. So, the reason why we're in the Great Ocean Temple and we're just now meeting Linebeck is because the software that I used to actually record through my phone, it crashed halfway through the trip to the Temple of the Ocean King. And I did not realize it because I have notifications blocked off for that app. And apparently it turns the notifications off for it as well. So that's what happened with that. So basically this temple's gimmick right now is the purple areas, as Linebeck says. They're safe areas. And you keep in those while whenever you go out, the temple will drain your life. And there's pots, the containers everywhere that have heart pieces. What I'm doing right here, I'm being stupid and I'm drawing like the path I'm going to take without using a stylus, of course, because I don't have one for my phone. And I think, oh, it's going to be a good idea to go to all of these areas and check out what they are. Because there's one blocked for the one where the ladder is, but the other one, I guess it was an unlocked door. This is my first time playing this in about maybe 11 years now. I hit this button thinking, oh, it's going to unlock the door. Nope, I'm wrong. So he gets freed, and he basically fucking runs like a bitch. So in that regard, I go in the center thinking maybe he left something. Nope. I go all the way to the other panels thinking, oh, there's going to be something here. And I see the treasure chest out of the corner of my eye. And nothing is here. So, kind of a disappointment. Nothing is in here. This is empty. Guess what the sign... Oh, wow. Linebeck took my shit. So, out of doing that, Ciela is basically torturing Linebeck, saying, oh, wow, you're so scared. Just the temple being kind of scary. What are you doing? You're not brave. Colton's the one who saved you. And Linebeck immediately attacks you, thinking you're trying to steal his treasure. And the look on Link's face during the scene is priceless. See, he's being a bitch, because he's spraining his ankle. Sorry if I'm being quiet through half of this, guys. It's my first time actually doing, a voice recording for anything, and I don't know how I'm gonna sound. I'm probably gonna sound like shit. I'm just using, audio software through my phone. And this is the scene I'm talking about. And there's about, I think, 3, maybe 4 cuts in the video from where I fucked up. I'll cut out the deaths and shit so you guys don't see that. Me erasing stuff on the map. I'll do all that kind of stuff. And here is the first transition right about now. I tried to do it somewhat decent, but I don't know how that worked. Basically what I did, I died the first time. Went through that, I was like, oh shit, I'm gonna dive right now again. But no. Go to the right on the path that I drew, it's easier. I didn't think that floor was there in the hole. The floor was there. I didn't think the hole was in the floor. So basically I'm just going through, falling. I should have took the path that I actually followed, the one that I made like a dumbass. I go through there, triggering both those, makes the spikes go down for me, and you don't have to worry about them. So I get full health, back again, only 3 hearts. decent for right now. So we're going through, I open up the chest. We get the sea chart, which is what helps us discover all the other isles that are out there. And another transition is coming up because I flubbed up. I think that is a cool transition though. Making my way back out through the temple, going through the middle area, which is quicker. And all of a sudden, Linebeck's gone. And of course, CL, I believe her fucking name is, I don't know. She's a support character. And a annoying ass fairy. I'm surprised to actually use the voice clip from, goddamn Ocarina of Time for her, because it has the, hey, listen, in there. And there's another transition coming up that kind of cuts quick right here. Just pause so you can read that. I basically redid the map. And there's one area where there's a big green reapy. I'll probably make a video next time saying where it is. I was like, oh, I can break that. It's the tree right there, right next to me. No, it's the one where the heart containers are. That's where the big green reapy is. Or it's the one I just rode past. Rolling for me was probably the hardest part figuring out how to do on the emulator. And there's parts, I believe, where you have to, like, blow into the DS mic. I'm not too sure. It's been a minute since I watched the first Trevor Conroy videos about Phantom Hourglass. I jump up here thinking, oh yeah, I can totally make that with Pico. And I was wrong. In a sense, I was deadly, deadly wrong. It's kind of surprising how fucking stupid I am for doing that. I actually don't know how you get up there. I really don't. I plan on figuring that out at some point. And my dumbass, of course, goes completely through the first part of the temple without a shield. And if I had not went to here just on an occasion, I would still not have the shield at the ending of this episode, so I'm actually kind of glad that I actually stopped and looked in this place. So basically, the Helmarok feather is something that was dropped in the, it's kind of a memento to, Wind Waker from the Helmarok team. And you defeat him in that game. It's actually a really, really good game. And I'm surprising. I know this game, I read, has a lot of flaws that a lot of people don't like. And I can see where a lot of those flaws come from. But at least it's not Spirit Tracks. That's the one good thing I can really say about this game. It is not Spirit Tracks. And thank freaking God for that. Because Jesus freaking Christ, I've heard Spirit Tracks is like stupid dumb. Like, this one I can see, but there's no red lines in this one, which is kind of sad because he's like your ship in the main game of Wind Waker. He is what you travel on. And the sailing on this is actually really quick, believe it or not. And this is a really cool mechanic, using the touchscreen inside of the DS with the stylus to reveal certain parts of the map. Or blowing on the map, I think is one of them. Snapping really quickly, or loudly like that. It solves a certain puzzle. I don't know which one. It, like, gets you a lower price on some fucking item. I saw that in one of Chugga's newest videos. I'm actually kind of glad, because I've been wanting to pick this game up for a while. I'm just, it cuts me right now, so don't really have the time to get my old DS out, charge it, all that shit, so. Yeah. An emulator will have to do. If I get in trouble, I get in trouble for using one, but a lot of people actually do it to play games. And the poll I put on there was like, we have a poll we can get to. Like, I think that's Dinspearl that's on the map at Ember Island. So, whenever there's a pearl in the area, I'm just gonna mark it like that. The X's on the map are kind of places nearby that I think Beetle goes to, so I usually will mark that down. And I get injured on the boat a lot, because the moving the screen on the phone for the emulator is kind of difficult to do, to be honest, so I might die on the ship a little bit, which I will cut out any deaths or anything like that. I'm gonna find a way to cut it out and not screw up the video too much. I know whenever I did fully record this thing, like for its max length, it was 20 something minutes, and I had to do about 4 minutes and 37 seconds of editing to cut it down. I'm not gonna do really long episodes after this. I'm gonna keep them down to about maybe 13-15 minutes. I'm not gonna do 30 minute like the first episode. That's just, you know, because it's the first episode. Like, right here, these things. You have to jump over them. And the jumper really has the tendency not to work. Like, I pressed it twice. And the third time I pressed it, where I actually jumped, it actually worked. I guess it's because the little touch button you see right there. I may have accidentally been pressing that at the time and not knowing it, so that's my fault right there, and I'm gonna have to get better with using the controls. And I'm sure I will as the time goes on. I'm just wanting to take a chillax playthrough throughout this game. I know I'm not gonna 100% it like Chugga is, and I may use his videos as reference. I'm gonna try and upload at least one video a day if I have the time. If not, it's gonna be a little bit of a pain if I try and do more than one episode a day. I'll record multiple in advance for reasons. Like, if I can't record one, I'll have one ready to upload. Because the first episode that I uploaded, it took about, I want to say, God, like 2 hours, just because it was so freaking long. And I fell asleep during the uploading process. And one of my friends, actually, I don't know if he's taken a look at it yet, but he's a really good friend of mine. He's a YouTuber. His name on YouTube is, Mr. Beauregard, so if you guys could just check him out, he's really funny. He's redneck as shit, just like me, so if you guys like that, go ahead and check him out. And basically, the sailing in this game, I will admit, is probably one of the best features. The only thing you have to control is the jump button for right now. Whenever we progress later on, you get a cannon, I believe a fishing pole, something like that, and you also get a salvage arm to use to dig for treasure. Which is kind of weird that Linebeck is a pirate and he doesn't have, like, anything to spill out for treasure underwater with. It's a fucking weird way of saying that. It's weird that he does not have a way to put the stuff, to grab stuff underwater with. You think he would have some type of attachment that he would use on his boat to dig for treasure that's underwater. I cannot do words today. It's weird that he also doesn't have a cannon at this moment either, but we have to buy both of those, if I remember correctly. I don't think the cannon was given, but, you know, I could be wrong. My memory's very foggy right now on Chubby's video, because he's on like episode 19 or 20 at this point. Whenever I'm uploading this, he may have uploaded more. It is very, very hard to say. and I'm trying to keep like a lot of messenger notifications off my phone, shit like that. And there is gonna be sometimes I will switch into the vertical mode just for the purpose of maybe rolling a lot better, because it's easier to do whenever it's like that. So if you guys don't want to see the vertical mode a lot, or if you don't want to see it at all, just let me know on what I can do better. And that's going to be the end of the video, guys. Thanks, and join again.